You know, it feels like my parents are getting divorced and I have to like choose.
You pick Ryan Johnson or Jar Jar Abrams.
And then what happens is I waited too long and they're like, fuck you, kid.
You know, he could have said anything he wanted. Like, I'm back, baby. Like some fucking mask shit. And I would have loved it. This is the best movie I've ever seen in my life.
I don't know if you just, if you looked over at me, but every time I kept on looking at you, you was just like stone cold. You're just like, at one point, so you're like, what the
f- Yeah, I want to take Ryan Johnson and any of the writers that were involved in any of these films and Kathleen Kennedy. I want to shake them. I want to slap them a bit.
Why?
You fools! What are you doing? What are you doing, you stupid?
Palpatine fucks, confirmed.
Palpatine fucks.
He fucks, confirmed.
Blurry sat here for like 30 minutes and figured out how to get the movie going.
Every single trailer was terrible except for the Tenet trailer. Now this is what we see.
This is probably better than the actual movie, so we're not complaining.
Oh, well, here we go.
Star Wars, what a send-off.
Oh god, dude, this is, at least John Williams was able to make this movie bearable
with his brilliance. You can hear him right now.
At least we got Hayden Christensen. I the, told you
the best the part of the movie is getting to hear one line from Hayden Christensen.
Yeah, two lines.
Two lines.
You underestimate my power.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, recording. So we just finished watching what we guessed was Star Wars. Whoa.
Jesus.
In the words of Keanu Reeves, whoa. And not in the good way. Not in the good way at all.
You know, in the beautiful sense of Tommy Wiseau's Star Wars.
Star Wars would have been a dream. But dream is dead now.
Dream nightmare.
First of all, they fucked up the first two movies. They could have saved it with the second movie, but then Ryan Johnson decided that he wanted to be original.
Be the cool artor that he
thinks he is. He wanted to be
is.
Experimental with fucking Star Wars. That's not what you do with Star Wars.
Yeah, Star Wars, you know what Star Wars is, and apparently Ryan Johnson didn't. So honestly, I don't know how you fuck up Star Wars.
How do you fuck up Star Wars?
This is how you fuck up Star Wars. This right here. The epitome of how you destroy. If George Lucas didn't already do it, then this is how you officially do it. So
Star Wars is a dream now. And what we saw was a bastardization. I even went in with the lowest of expectations.
Yeah, I went in with less than no expectations. And I was still disappointed. So
it was just ass pull after ass pull after ass pull.
Yeah, so they decided that since Rey was already way too OP in the other two movies, that they're gonna like, oh, you know what, let's make her even more powerful by letting her be able to just, you know.
I thought Anakin was the most powerful. I thought they called him Jesus. Wasn't he was the Jesus?
He was the chosen one. And so I guess these guys are God then.
Yeah,
so.
I mean, I'm not, no spoilers. I don't.
Okay, I will give spoilers because fuck it. If you don't want spoilers, then stop watching right now. Yeah, our rating for the movie is a 5 green lightsabers out of -13 Palpatines.
Do it.
My rating is 1 Luke Skywalker
out of
10 blue milks.
And 1 Han Solo.
1 Han Solo. Come home, Zion.
That's a spoiler.
Well, he did the Force Awakens. Who fucking cares about any of these movies? Fucking hell.
So I guess you can just bring people back to life now. You know, the thing that Anakin fucking turned to the dark side for and destroyed his entire
life. Holy shit.
And killed all of the fucking Jedi and lose everything he loved. That they can
just fucking realize that.
It on a whim now. Just Phoenix down their fucking...
Jesus Christ!
Anyone they want.
Do you know what that means? That means the prequels don't matter.
Basically. And also the fact that Palpatine has a daughter now, I guess.
And then, when did he get the time to fuck? I bet he did the fucking midichlorian bullshit. I read a theory that apparently he was the one that put the midichlorians into Shimmy Skywalker.
At this point, that might as well be canon. Fuck me. Honestly, this is about as good as this movie could have been. You can do better than this.
Yeah, I mean, the visuals were like...
For as much of a clusterfuck as a story,
yeah,
inevitably
it was very pretty to watch.
It was... The best thing about this trilogy is the cinematography,
yeah,
and John Williams.
I told you already, but like, there was a point while I was watching the movie where my stomach started to hurt, and I was like, I felt it in my bones. I was like, this is not... I shouldn't be in here. But then I heard all the triumphant music of John Williams and...
The saving grace.
He brought me back to life.
He was even the saving grace of the prequels. The best thing about the prequels was the music. It was fucking amazing. Like, the prequels had some of John Williams' best work wasted on a terribly written story. As well as here.
Yeah, the main takeaway from the prequels I had was the music and the choreography. And that was it. And then, like, I tried to look for that here. And it was different, though. It was cinematography and music. That's really all I got from these movies. Yeah. And then, this was a big fucking giant ass nostalgia, hard on, like, jerk off session.
So many fucking, okay, let's bring them all back.
Let's bring them all back and just kill them all and leave one of poor Chewie.
Poor Chewie loses all of his loved ones. Everybody dies. Everybody's dead. All the old people.
Yeah, all
except
the old,
for Lando.
Yeah. JJ was like, fuck all these old people. You know how, like, Michael Jordan's like, fuck them kids. Like, I thought I'd be just happy seeing cool callbacks with Luke coming back as a Force ghost. I'd be like, oh, I just felt poor Mark Hamill.
Basically, everything, every story beat, it's like, oh, that's how they're trying to save it.
It's literally what they did in every single one. They're like, oh, you remember these guys? Oh, it's Han Solo. Leia's here in this one, too.
Oh, and since everyone else can just bring people back, let's have her, like... Pull an Amidala and just...
Pull an Amidala?
just die and bring life, I guess, because that's how the Force works.
In the words of the wise old Han, that's not how the Force works.
Was it hokey religions and ancient weapons?
Will this stop my love of Star Wars? Probably not. I have episodes 4, 5, and 6. You have what you love. And I don't love this.
At least we got to experience a real Star Wars movie live.
Oh, the
episode
yeah,
5.
Yeah, the orchestra.
Empire
when we went
Strikes
to go watch
Back,
the orchestra.
We saw
yeah.
Empire Strikes Back with a live orchestra, and that was fucking amazing.
That was so much emotion just watching that. And then, I don't know if you just, if you looked over at me, but every time I kept on looking at you, you was just like stone cold. Just, you're just like, at one point you're like, what the f-?
It's true. I wasn't even surprised at anything that happened in the movie. I was just like, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I don't know. During my whole, there was a scene where, like, there was a scene where she's like, I am all the Jedi. And then they show all the...
Rey. Back the balance, Rey, as I did. Every Jedi who ever lived lives in you.
The Force surrounds you, Rey.
Let it guide you, Rey.
Let it lift you.
Rise, Rey.
I wish they fucking showed him. Imagine if we saw Hayden Christian.
This
would have been a 10 out of 10 movie. Right then
we've
there.
Gone so far over to the other side that we fucking love Hayden Christensen now.
If we were the Jedis, if we were Jedis at the temple and he was killing younglings, I would have killed younglings right with him.
Let me help you with that, Master Skywalker.
We would be one of the
just
younglings.
Slaughtering. Killing them. Master Skywalker, there are too many of... Oh, this kid needs to die.
That's what, like, happened, apparently, with the Jedi Temple Guard. Apparently, they just were like, fuck it, and then joined in. So I guess we would be the Jedi Temple Guard.
Okay, join the dark side, fuck it. That was basically, like, almost a quarter of this movie is just fuck it. No, actually, all of this movie is fuck it.
It's like, is it fuck it because Rian Johnson did what he
did?
Or is it just like...
It's about 40%
Rian Johnson. Amalgamation.
40% Rian Johnson, 40% The Force Awakens. And about 200% shit. Disney, that's what.
Disney's and their money. You know what the best part about this is, man?
Disney still wins.
They still win.
We lose.
They got our fucking... You know, I wanted to watch this movie after the weekend so that we could see it on like a Monday. So we'd buy tickets to a different movie and just go inside.
I know, man. Just go watch like a Jumanji. I would have rather put my money on Jumanji.
That
would have
been a better time.
I would have had a better time watching Rock and Kevin Hart do their shenanigans than Ray and Finn and Poe. Also, what is up with that fucking love triangle bullshit?
They fucking... The story is just such a clusterfuck with the
Kylo
characters.
Ren and Ray.
Basically, J.J. Abrams were like, all right, you know what? Fuck all that stuff Rian Johnson did. Kind of fuck all the stuff, like... Just fuck all the stuff, you know? I'm just gonna do this. And be really good at the visuals and then fuck everything else.
We should do like a drinking game where with how many times Finn yells, Ray! 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 Just kept on doing it. Also, I will say though, like in the movie's defense, or rather in, forgot the actor's name who plays Poe. Like every time I watched him, I was like, oh, he's very good.
Yeah, he's trying.
At least I'm like, oh, finally.
He's trying and he's completely out of place.
The movie's wasted on him.
He just doesn't fit in.
I know. Because he's really the only one good.
Okay, this like could be a well-developed, charismatic, interesting character. And then these fucking cardboard pieces. I'll give props to the main cast for trying.
True. They really tried their best.
They did what they could with this garbage.
The poor girl who played... Rose.
She got completely sidelined.
She's literally sidelined. Poor girl.
J.J. Abrams like that, but I don't like this character.
He like gave in to like the toxic fans. And we're not toxic fans here.
We're not toxic fans. We're just toxic people. Yeah. So yeah, we're the people you don't want in your lives. If you couldn't tell from us completely ruining this movie for you,
if you were excited like I was, then give it to your hatred.
They needed more Return of the Jedi.
What an asshole. They're like, oh, the main villain was Palpatine. All fucking, along. Fucking, like that, it that was for that all was, three movies.
Literally.
All three sagas. The main villain was Palpatine.
You see, this, I would actually buy into that if they knew what they were doing with this at the beginning. But they had not even
you
a single
You know who
clue.
Did a good job of doing the main villain throughout the whole series? Fucking Voldemort.
Fucking Ray Fiennes. The movie basically opens with Kylo Ren meeting Palpatine. And at that point, I knew exactly what this movie was going to be.
Yeah, essentially, like,
basically,
beat for beat.
Retreading their tracks, desperately trying to make something happen.
In a sense, this kind of felt like Force Awakens, where they were like, where's Luke? Instead, they're like, where's Palpatine?
Huh? I mean, look, there are actually, the retreads that they were trying to do might have actually worked if they tried to do that from the beginning of this story. What I felt like with The Last Jedi is basically, besides all the bullshit, Rian Johnson trying to do reversals at every single point he can possibly fucking get his rocks off with.
He literally did a Knives Out. Like, he thought he was writing Knives Out when he wrote.
Basically, just like, oh, this is what you expect, even though, like, it makes sense with the story and it's probably better. But, fuck it, since it's what you expect, I don't want to do it. So I'm just going to fucking Luke saber throw over the shoulder to the entire movie. So, basically, what I felt with The Last Jedi, besides all that shit, is that it's what the final movie should have been. They did all that climactic
yeah,
shit in
that's
that
what everybody
movie.
Says,
and I'm
I
like, what are you
that.
Doing? You're supposed to be developing the characters. You're supposed to be putting them through trials, putting them at their lowest points, and fucking beating them down to the fucking Peter Parker, Spider-Man 2.
Please, I need this job.
You're fired.
Get it done, or I'm failing you.
Isn't that right?
Huh, brother?
But my best friend can't make an 8 o'clock curtain. He's nothing to me but an empty seat.
Oh, Miss Mary Jane Watson just agreed to marry me.
Uncle Ben was killed that night for being the only one who did the right thing.
That's what you need to be doing in this second movie. Instead, we just got a bunch of climactic fighting with no setup and no payoff.
And in this movie, we got even less payoff because now you have...
Like, we already know what happened.
Now you have two movies of just, like, that you don't know what you're even doing anymore.
Literally, the both movies are just noise at this point.
Because the first movie is basically...
What do we do here? First movie was setting this up.
First movie was retreading everything fine. You could get away with that once. Then you gotta try something new. And then Rian Johnson decided to try something new in every single possibly wrong way. Every single wrong way.
He goes off on a different type of spectrum when he does that. Like, oh, well, you know what? There aren't even Jedi anymore.
They're fucking no more Jedi. Let's just kill the fucking Snoke. He's nothing.
Snoke didn't even matter. You know what the funniest thing is? They fixed that right off the bat. They fixed it.
They slapped a giant band-aid on it. And
yeah, they're like, I was Snoke on it.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Basically what he did.
That's literally the beginning of the fucking movie.
And it's like, JJ's like, that's how it is. The audience better eat that up. And then, you know what? Pretty much most of the audience was like, yes. Whoa, that's genius.
Of course.
Not trying to dog on people who enjoy this film. You can enjoy this film if you want to.
We don't care, honestly, at this point. We're just
giving our own thoughts on this.
Shit talking, but by we don't care, we mean we really don't care anymore.
Really, honestly. Fuck, man.
Fucking Star Wars is lost. It died with...
You see this? You see this right here? I wish I was high.
Honestly, this movie would have been a better time.
I think I would have enjoyed this movie. Yeah, I 100% still... If Hayden Christensen just randomly popped up.
If they... apparently, he was supposed to appear in the actual
Like, here's my cut of Rise of Skywalker. All of a sudden, Rey's down on her feet. She's like, oh. And it's Palpatine's like looking at her down. Yeah, or whatever the fuck he said. I don't fucking know. All of a sudden, you hear lightsabers. Oh, is it Ben? No. No. Hayden Christensen.
Hayden Christensen.
You see that poop come out. Boom.
You underestimate my power, Palpatine.
You may have swayed me once, but not again. And I'm like, oh.
I'm Skywalker.
Rey Skywalker.
You know, he could have said anything he wanted.
He could have said, like,
I'm back, baby. Like some fucking mask shit. And I would have loved it. I'd have been like, this is the best movie I've ever seen in my life.
Fucking channeling Jim Carrey.
Speaking of which, we gotta watch the fucking Sonic movie.
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is not a Sonic 20-minute video. This is
not Star Wars. This is Disney Wars.
The Disney Wars. We are the rebellion.
We're the rebels, the real rebels that found peace in Return of the Jedi with the dancing Ewoks.
Which also made an appearance in this movie.
For some reason.
You know, there is a reason. The nostalgia factor.
Of course. You have to have all the stuff. All the stuff in this movie.
This is the end of my journey.
This is the end for you, my master.
You can't, Anakin.
I have the high ground.
I saw a GIF where he's saying that, and then literally cuts to a scene of him fighting Darth Maul, and he has fucking...
Yeah.
Darth Maul has the high ground, and he's like, what? He gets fucking cut in half.
Yeah, because high ground totally makes sense. When they've literally been fucking flying around platforms for the past 6 minutes.
I know, it's like, couldn't they have... I'm gonna cut off his legs right now.
That is one thing. The one problem I have with the fighting in the prequels is that, number one, since you don't really care about the characters and they're so underdeveloped, none of the fighting has any story behind it. And the only way you're supposed to do a great fight scene is by having character dynamics in the actual fight. Like in the original trilogy where you have Luke and Vader and there's actual character development going on while the fight is going on.
And the thing is with the prequels and then the fight scenes, what really was the character was the music, because that was like literally what
basically
was so heart pounding. I wasn't like, Obi-Wan and Anakin, they're fucking fighting. And I'll be like, literally. No, damn, like this fucking music is like heart wrenching. Like I could feel that emotion. But then when you see them do it, it's like, they're not doing anything at all. John Williams is doing everything he possibly
basically
can.
John Williams carried the whole fucking prequel.
He carried the whole franchise. At least the prequels and the sequel.
We're recording both of
us, by the way, for some reason.
20 minutes of... It's funny, too, because, like, our Interstellar video was, like, 3 minutes long, and we're just like, oh! By the way, we should do that for Tenet when it comes out.
That was the only preview that was of any worth. I don't know what was going on. We literally had, like, 40 minutes of previews. Because we went in late, like, 10 minutes late, and then there's still, like, half an hour more of previews.
Okay, I'm going to end this recording, and...
I'm not going to end this.
Just continue on.
This is going to be, like, a whole hour. I'm going to take you through our entire night.
We're gonna go to Denny's after this.
We have special connections with Denny's.
I'll end it here.
Yeah. Whoa.
We're still going. We're still going. So let's... Because I know we're going to have more thoughts. I need the rest of the Dragon Balls to fix this franchise.
We need Shenron.
No, we don't need Shenron. We need that Namek one. Three wishes. Fix... each movie.
We need to fucking gather the Dragon Balls, and that'll be a better movie than what we got. That's our Star Wars, is getting the Dragon Balls.
Doing Dragon Ball instead of Star Wars. That would be a better Star Wars movie, Dragon Ball.
Well, I will say this. This movie was better than Dragon Ball Evolution. So, oh, and that's saying absolutely nothing.
That's true. There was a time in my life when I was so excited for Star Wars. You know, I went to fucking Disneyland, and I lived Star Wars. And I come back home, you would think I'd be excited for the new movie. But I'm just like, it just hurts. I'd rather just go back to Galaxy's Edge.
That's the only thing you did right, apparently.
You know what? Either way, like I said, Disney fucking wins. They got my
They're
money.
They're getting everyone's money.
Like, this is not the end of Star Wars. They're gonna milk this teat for its last drop. Milk this blue milk fucking thing.
Fucking The Last Jedi style. Fuck. I hate this movie less than I hate The Last Jedi.
I know. You have a lot of problems with The Last Jedi.
It's so funny. That's the one movie, at least of recent, that I hate even more the more I think about it.
Yeah, you know what? When I watched this movie, because I went in with such low expectations, it was less of a burn. And then when I watched Last Jedi, when I initially watched it, I was like, oh, this is good. And then, like, the more I thought about it, the angrier I got because they made me think it was good.
I know. I walked out of The Last Jedi. I walked out, I was like, I think that was okay.
That's when you know a movie is not good. That's why I hate The Last Jedi. It's not because it's not just a bad movie, but because it made me believe that it was a good one.
The problem is that The Last Jedi was really their chance to try and do something interesting with these movies. And they completely fucking Rian Johnson just had to.
Like, we get it, dude. Like, we get it, okay? Like, just don't do it on Star Wars, please.
You had...
Just don't fuck up Star Wars for us.
You had the galaxy in the palm of your hand, and you said...
Do it.
Whoop.
Fuck that.
All coming together will be your undoing.
Which is what happened. JJ and Rian both came together and undid Star Wars. Just what I thought.
I'm not gonna blame JJ as much as I'm gonna blame Rian Johnson for this. I feel like JJ at least makes a competent movie.
True.
Whereas Rian Johnson seems to not understand writing. And I mean, that's not to say that the writing in this movie was good at all, but at least it didn't make me hate what I was watching. It just made me not care.
What a perfect, yeah, perfect, that's how summation. I feel. A summation of how I feel about Star Wars right now. I just don't care.
I stopped caring with The Last Jedi. We just watched this movie because the obligation.
Yeah, I also wanted to do
I wanted to see how people would react. And of course, we just had to see how they were going to try and save this. Yeah. I blame Disney the most.
I really do too.
I blame Kathleen Kennedy. She's the true emperor, true empress.
Yeah, that was just something I was thinking about. How is it that Kevin Feige was able to single-handedly
create an entire empire of cinematic films?
And they're like competent films. And then Kathleen Kennedy has whatever, 5 fucking, I don't know, Solo and Rogue One and bullshit. How did she fuck up that? Feige had 20.
And I mean, he like had some missteps, but
yeah, but see the end result. Do I want more Star Wars? I don't know. Do you think
I wanted more Star Wars. I wanted it. There's some people that say there's like nothing that you can do any, like what you do is Star Wars, just do it again. Like exactly
it's
what they
literally
did.
Yeah,
but that's not true. You have so much you could do.
so much like, good you can do.
Like, the Knights of the Old Republic games came over once, and we just watched, like, a 20-minute compilation of the cutscenes. Oh, my
Knights
God.
Knights of the Old Republic, those CG short films, are about 15 times better than anything we saw tonight.
Which is why I'm going to ask you, because they are going to, they're making a Coder Saga, and it's Ryan Johnson. So what do I do?
Ryan Johnson, if you have even half a brain cell left.
If you were somehow come across this Facebook / YouTube video, whatever this is.
But fuck it, this is an open letter to you. Please.
Coder is like the last thing I have left.
This is the last remnant of anything potentially halfway good that might come out of Star Wars, and if I see even a teaser, if I see 15 seconds of Ryan Johnsoning going on, then we're gonna kill ourselves.
I'm gonna fucking one bullet, one Glock.
We're gonna fucking unforce ourselves the opposite of what they did in this
What movie. Ben and Ray did? I don't even want to call him Ben, man. Did you like the
You
whole...
know, they had, apparently, people picked up on some sexual tension in The Last Jedi, Kylo and Ray, because he had, his fucking shirtless scene for some reason, which...
By the way, man, that man is massive.
Listen, I'll give you props to that fucking Adam Driver. Your face is kind of weird, but your body's pretty nice.
Like the definition of ugly hot.
Which I still don't understand what Ryan Johnson was thinking when he thought that was a good idea.
And then I guess
shirtless, might as well bring on some Tommy Wiseau music.
Put on some Tommy Planet underwear. I see you, Ray.
Why you got a shirt off, bro? Fucking put a goddamn shirt on.
Even Ray was thinking it. She's like, I don't want to see that shit.
Do you have something, a cowl or something you can put on?
I guess whatever they picked up on is confirmed in this movie because they kiss.
I think J.J. Abrams like, I like that. I'm gonna make that happen.
God, it felt so forced, you know?
Forced.
Forced.
That's basically how I feel about this entire trilogy.
They took the Force too seriously.
They were too forced.
They didn't listen to Han, man.
And hokey religions and ancient weapons are no match for a good blaster.
Yeah.
I enjoyed Harrison Ford
coming back.
That's the only comeback that I felt was
I will say I saw what they were trying to do with Kylo.
What I said this from the beginning, since The Force Awakens, Kylo Ren was the only potentially interesting character.
But here's where they fucked it up. The fact that they killed him off. You know what it feels like? It feels like my parents are getting divorced. And I have to, choose.
You pick Ryan Johnson or Jar Jar Abrams.
And then what happens is I waited too long and they're like, fuck you, kid.
Honestly, I don't even know what they could have possibly done to save this trilogy.
Still don't think Kylo should have died.
First of all, I don't even think they should have had those fucking powers.
Jesus powers.
You fucking gave them new life powers.
Something that Anakin Skywalker has been looking for.
The entire point of the prequels, which... By the way, as terribly written as they were, the story was there. The writing was dog shit, but the story was there.
Because so, it had a basis.
There was an arc.
Which the sequels had! They had it!
They could have had it.
I'm gonna have an aneurysm, man.
I feel like if they, like I said, if they thought about these fucking plot points from the beginning.
That's the thing, Chris.
And worked them in.
That's why it's so infuriating. There are good points of these movies, but the bad points overshadow it. They could have done something.
I just want to take Ryan Johnson, maybe JJ. You can direct movies, but fuck. I want to take Ryan Johnson and any of the writers that were involved, any of these films, and Kathleen Kennedy, I want to shake them. I want to slap them a bit.
Why?
I want to take...
I don't know if you just say whatever you're about to say.
I want to take a Glock.
I don't know about that.
At everybody's faces and say, you fools! What are you doing? What are you doing, you stupid? No!
You just drop the Glock. You're still holding on to this.
Yes, that's good, but don't do all that. No!
Chris killed himself on camera, so.
Oh!
I used my ass pull powers.
Oh, no!
You're not with me. You're my enemy. Only a Sith deals in absolutes. That was an absolute statement.
Maybe Anakin, maybe he was onto something here. From my point of view, the Jedi are evil.
Well, then you are lost.
It shows a lot that we can quote prequel to the end of the earth, and I can't remember one line from the sequels that is noteworthy. The thing is, like,
the lines are as memorable as the characters, which is not.
Palpatine fucks, confirmed.
Palpatine fucks.
He fucks, confirmed.
He fucks.
Hey, you know what? If Palpatine that greasy, like, old fucking... if he can fuck, anybody can fuck, dude. Incels, any incels watching this right now? You guys have any shot in the world of...
Oh, strong.
You just see Hayden Christians.
I will do whatever you ask.
All right, let's continue this into the Denny's. Yeah, bad movies give me a big appetite.
They'll at least control our anger.
Good.
Let the hate flow to you like my cum flows to your mouth.
Oh, Jesus.
Any Pornhub people watching, if you guys need a Palpatine voice actor,
we're going to upload this on Pornhub.
Yeah, we're going
to. Yeah, fuck uploading this.
Two guys get fucked by Star Wars. Two guys get fucked by Star Wars producer.
Fucked by Disney.
Two guys, one Disney.
I'm not even lying. I'm going to make a Pornhub account. I'm going to fucking upload this.
That will be the very first Pornhub video I link to people.
People get I think you got hacked. Nah.
Nah. You got to watch this. That's sweet.
Okay. I'm still rolling.
You had three movies to build an empire. And in this, you have no movies to build an empire. They're just back. It's like if we had World War II, and then Vietnam War came around, and all the Nazis just are back, taking over Vietnam. And nobody knows why they want Vietnam.